back to WhatGear Reviews, and if I'm looking a bit scruffier than normal today, it's because it's my day off, but I'm not slowing down. I'm doing part two of the ActionCam review. Part one, we did a bit of comparison between the GoPro 2 and the ActionCam, and it was a great day. And if you haven't checked it out, you need to, and you can find out exactly how this happened to my head. So check that video out. Trust me, it's a good one. Anyway, today we're doing part two of the ActionCam review, and I'm testing it in a different way, and you might be wondering how. So here we go, I'll try and show you now. Okay, jump here. I've rigged up my dog with an ActionCam, and we're gonna go for a walk with our friends, Jack and Russell, the Jack Russells, and you can see what they get up to from Kaya's point of view, and it's gonna be fun. And this is a Staffordshire Terrier here, a really high energy dog. So yeah, this is really gonna put it through its paces. We're gonna see how good the image stabilization is. Yeah, it's gonna be fun.
Are you ready to go? Tell him.
Just pulled up, and this is what I've been dealing with the whole bloody way. Look at that, the entire journey. This is what I've been listening to, and I'm about to let them out. So yeah, let's get ready. So I just let him out of the car just now, and the ActionCam is actually angled upwards already. It might be because I didn't tighten it properly, but yeah, it's all right now. Seems to be holding up, and I'm just gonna follow their progress, and I'm gonna switch between the ActionCam footage and this footage. Both of these are Sony cameras, but the time lapse on the way here was actually my phone, which is a Galaxy Note 3. So Sony, if you feel like giving me a Z3 to test out, feel free. So it wouldn't be England if it wasn't raining, and guess what? It's raining. What a surprise.
But at least we get to test out the waterproof capabilities of the ActionCam. Now, I'm noticing a bit of fog on the actual casing of the ActionCam, just generated by the heat from running around, I guess. I hope it's not affecting the footage too badly. Into the woods we go. Disaster has just struck. She's run through a bush and managed to knock the ActionCam clean off. Now hopefully it hasn't been damaged. I'm about to recover it now. Now you can see it's fogged up, and I'm actually running it on 720p mode. So I'm actually going to test out the 1080 now. just to see how it compares, if there's a massive difference, a visible difference. So I'm gonna let it unfog, I'm gonna put it in 1080p, and then I'm gonna strap it back onto the back of Kaya, and hopefully she's not gonna run through any more bushes, but that isn't guaranteed, unfortunately. And I hope she doesn't drop this anywhere where I can't recover it. I actually don't have any coins or anything to unscrew this off the mount, so I actually can't open it up and clear that fog out, which is definitely a problem. It would be great if there was something attached to the device itself which you could use as a tool to unscrew this thing. But as you can see, it still hasn't quite cleared up yet. I'm going to keep moving now. I've been sitting here for a little while and it hasn't really improved that dramatically. I'm going to give it maybe 5 more minutes and then I'll hook it back onto the dog. I lost my keys the other day, as I mentioned in part one of my action cam review. So I actually don't even have those to use to unwind, to unscrew the bolt on the bottom of the camera. I don't have anything that's gonna fit that. If I find something lying around, I'll be able to do it. But at this point, I can't clean the fog off the lens. Now, this is about midway through the normal dog walk that I take the guys on. And I've had to stop twice to defog. She's knocked it off once. That's not really a bad thing, because if you think about it, you're going down the mountain with one of these on your head, and snowboarding or skiing. If you catch your head, or the camera, let's say, on a branch, you don't want it to take your head clean off. You do want it to break away. So that's actually quite good. She might have hung herself up on a branch, and then I'd have to go into the bloody bushes to free her up. So it's actually a good little system there, where it breaks off with relative ease. Obviously it stays solid when she's running around, which is great. So that's, I guess it's kind of a safety feature that does work. I have just, by chance, found this bit of ruler lying around out here in the wild. I feel like Bear Grylls right now, surviving out here in the wilderness. And I've just discovered a life-saving tool. It is a piece of broken ruler, which I can only assume has come from the university, which I actually went to for a few years and studied computer science. So look at that. What a strange coincidence.
1080p mode. I'm going to do this for about 10 minutes and I'm going to destroy the memory card.
This is England for sure, and it's about to start down proper. We're under a little bit of shelter here. There's like a biking track area, like a loads of jumps and stuff, and hopefully you're gonna get Kaya to run over a few of them. Yeah, let's do it. So I'm about to head into the thick of the woods. The action cam is still on 1080p mode. I'm a little bit concerned because I don't know how much memory this thing's using up. But I have got a 64 megabit card in there, which is quite large. It is a micro SD card because the ActionCam only takes micro SD or M2, if you can find an M2 anywhere. Yeah, so I'm going to switch it back into 720 now, I think, just so we can complete the journey without any worries. I have noticed that when I switched it back from 1080 that it is starting to fog up again, which is a problem, which means I'm going to have to use my trusty ruler, which I found like Bear Grylls out in the wood, and undo this thing and do it back up again just to clean off that fog. What a pain in the ass that is. I'm sure there are plenty of solutions you could buy which will stop that from happening for a bit longer, but you know what, I didn't think of that when I bought this thing. Nice. Kaya, you're gonna have a wash later. A wash. Ah, get out.
Clean the lens a few times, it got knocked off once, it's been in the water. Yeah, so far the durability is good. The dog harness is also holding up. Kaya's happy to wear it, it's not uncomfortable for her. She's not really showing any signs of trying to get it off. So that's perfect. I mean, so far so good. Let's get home and check out the footage.
Back in the car now, and this camera's literally ran out of battery. My phone, the Galaxy S3, Galaxy Note 3 is also out of battery. So I'm actually gonna try something with the ActionCam, because it's the only one that's got any battery left. I'm gonna try time lapse the journey home, and we will see how well it handles motion and stability. But saying that, stability has probably already been pretty heavily tested with the dog and the previous video. But anyway, let's give it a go, see what we get. Should be interesting.